Hello, my friends, and welcome. My name is Emily, and we're here today to do some virtual studio digital painting. You can see our event up on the screen here. Today, we are going to be learning about Pixlr E, which is a free online program for photo editing or digital painting. And today, we're going to work on drawing a scene from Kitchener's Victoria Park. We're going to use basic tools and brushes in the newly updated Pixlr E. Today we get to explore how to use layers, how that can help you with your drawing. We're going to experiment with different brushes and have lots of fun. I'm hoping you'll add to your project different animals. In the photo you'll see we have some ducks that are flying away, but maybe you'll like to add in maybe Otis the swan or some squirrels or anything that you like. So first of all, I'd like to introduce you to our photo inspiration. I have that here. This is a photo I took the other day, and you can see it's a nice sunset over the trees, and we have some ducks that were playing around, but they decided to take off. So let's see what we can do in Pixlr. We're going to focus on drawing a tree, drawing some water, having some fun with the sky. Look at all those fun colors that we have there, and maybe we can add some animals. But most of all, I hope you enjoy your introduction to Pixlr E and learn a few new things about drawing something online. This software is totally free in your browser, and perhaps once you're finished with your drawing, you might save it and maybe you'll send it off via email to someone that you care about. It will cheer them up. All right, my friends, moving right along, let's get over to Pixlr.com. So I've typed it in here for you, Pixlr.com. Then what we need, today we're selecting the Advanced Pixlr E. So we'll choose that now. So this is a Photoshop editor. Wonderful. So now let's go create new. For our picture, let's do a full HD. That'll give us a big canvas to work on. And next, we're going to select the background. By default, it's just a transparent background, but I think we will appreciate having a white background today. And let's hit create. Awesome. So, just like in class, we will play around with some brushes first before we get to creating our painting. Let me introduce you to a few of the tools we'll be using today. This one right here is the draw tool. All right, so we've got different brushes and colors to choose from, and let's play around with a few of those now. So let's select the brush. I'm going to select the black color there. And let's see what we have just by default here. Oh, super cool. Okay. If we want to change our brush, we've got a whole bunch to choose from here. Let's see. We could paint with stars and stamps, all different ones. Let's see what this one looks like. All right. Very nice. And for a lot of our painting, we will probably be just using these ones here. It is totally up to you. They have a nice softness level there. Let's try that one. Okay. And what about this one? What does that look like? Okay. So far we've found our brush tool. We found where we can adjust the size or the softness of the brush. Maybe choosing a few different brushes, but we've also looked at how we change our colors. So let's choose a new color. Maybe since we'll probably be doing some water today, let's choose some blue. And let's see what we can do there. Okay, that's neat. Okay, so we made a really good mess so far. Now let's play around with a couple other things. Let's go over to the eraser. And maybe erase a little bit. Maybe I didn't want this part. Okay, so we've got a good eraser there. We can also bump up the size of the eraser so we can erase super fast. So yeah, here we go. Let's wipe all that out for now. Okay, nice clean canvas. Now, to show you another tool we'll be using today, I want to start out with the brush tool and with that one there. I also want to do maybe a bit of outlining, but I think we'll just outline maybe in a gray. You can choose any gray, doesn't matter. For our purpose, this is another just test for learning the tool, so don't worry about making anything too perfect this time. Or any time, because this is all just for fun. So let's make some kind of skyline there. And I want to see if we could make some kind of river. So sometimes let's make our river like so. And maybe I'll kind of fall along there. Then I think the river kind of goes this way a little bit. All right. So let's say we want to fill in some of these spaces, because it's always nice to get your canvas fully covered before you start doing any more details. And I want to show you the fill tool here. So let's choose, what color do we want our water? I don't know. Let's see. Maybe a nice gray blue to start. And let's grab our fill tool. If we have drawn from edge to edge, as we have done here, and you can't quite see because I know I've gone off the canvas a little bit, but we should be able to fill in certain spots. So let's see if we get that to work. Perfect. So we filled in our water. Now let's get some green grass. Although I know it's sunset, so it seems like everything is a little darker, a little more muted. Okay, let's try that for our grass. Awesome. And I know we had a sunset there as well, so let's start with a nice general sky color. Maybe a nice yellow. Okay, so remember, we're going to be using a lot of layers today, so we are going to change this up a lot. This is just our base layer to give us an idea of what we want to do. And on top of this, we can create another layer and paint on top of that and adjust from there. That makes it really fun because if you make any mistakes along the way, you're just working with one layer at a time. So for example, let's put a tree in on a second layer here. So moving over to our layers, let's hit the plus sign here. And we're gonna use an empty layer. Awesome. So that just means we can paint on top. And let's show you how that works here. First, I'm gonna grab a dark color. Since a lot of things are in silhouette since the sunset. So let's draw our tree. And remember, this is all a little bit of fun. So it doesn't have to be perfect. Okay, so we've got our tree stump there. And then it looked like this tree, it's all kind of sparking out. So almost like each layer has two arms coming up somewhere there. I like how abstract it's going to be. And then I just want you guys to see the layer and how we can move it around. So let's choose this arrange tool. Basically, it's going to highlight what you painted on your layer so you're able to move it around your painting, which is really cool and something I'd love to be able to do with a real painting. So say we didn't really want our tree there. Maybe we wanted to move it down a little bit, maybe over a little bit. Maybe on this side. All right. Very cool. And I wonder. Yeah, we can duplicate our layer. Let's see if we can get a couple trees going here. Oh, this is going to save us tons of time. Lovely. We can also resize our new layer. And continue on from there. So let's practice our skill with that one more time, because I think it would be fun to go from yellow to a bit of that blue-gray. So let's use our select tool again. That's up here at the top right there, marquee select. And this time let's just select a little bit there at the top. And let's grab our gradient tool again. This time I have chosen a blue. Maybe I'll even try more of a gray blue this time. Okay, and then the same steps as before. So just click and hold. All right, it looks like I got mine a little bit off to the side, but you know, I kind of like that. Perfect. So let's start adjusting a few more things. We've got our sky layer figured out. That's layer 5, and that's looking really good. But now I would like to go over to our trees again. And let's figure out which is which. So let's use that select tool. Oh, pardon me. Let's go select and then deselect. There we go. That got rid of our marquee tool, and now we can select our trees. So I think it might be fun to add a bit more detail to our trees. And there's another tool that's really fun for that, and that's the pen tool. I think everyone will like this a lot. Again, there's lots of different ones we can choose from. I think I really liked the furry one. And again, we're going to have to select the color that we want for this. And let's give that a try. What if we add a little detail to our tree there? That looks kind of fun. Basically, I was just going along the arms and adding a little bit of this fur, I guess. Kind of want to think about how do branches usually look. I think usually there's not too much near the sides, and then they come out there a little bit. Very nice, very nice. And yeah, feel free to play around with that. I hope everyone's having lots of fun doing some drawing today. And I think I went a little too far there, so I'm just gonna hit undo. You can use Control Z to do undo, or you can just go edit, undo. Okay, yeah. Got a nice looking tree coming along here now. There's lots of fun we can have with these tools, for sure. I know we usually ask this question in class, but I'm wondering what your answers would be now. One of those would you rather questions is, would you rather go a year without technology or a year without any desserts or candy? So maybe a fun would you rather question to think about as you're doing your digital painting. I have a feeling your answer might have something to do with technology this time. And we really appreciate you joining us and drawing along with us today. I hope you will send in your drawings. All right. My tree is looking a little spooky, I think, but maybe I'll add a bit more. And remember, it's all just about having fun, so can be as silly as you want. Maybe your trees are from another planet and they look totally different than this tree. It'd be fun to see some space trees. Okay. Yeah, that's coming along now. Nice. Sometimes they really do reach up for the sky. Maybe we'll add a couple more there. There we go. Oh, that's looking great. Okay. Wonderful. So let's choose our tree again. And remember, we can duplicate them and change them. So maybe I shrink these little trees down a little bit more. Maybe I'll place them probably a little below the horizon. Let's see. About duplicating the layer. Yeah, I love this. This is so handy. So we can duplicate them and we can resize them. Maybe that'll make them look a little bit like not exact clones of each other there. To fill in some of our spaces here. So we just clicked on those three little dots there. I know I did that really fast, but you can click on those dots, duplicate them, move them around. Maybe this is a bigger one. Let's see. Probably that means he's closer. All right. I bet you too, we could even flip them, give some variety. Very cool. Okay, let's see. How about another one? Yeah. This one. Yeah, we flip them there. That's cool. Okay. This one, let's make him even more serious. Awesome. Duplicate. There we go. The layer's just there. That's even easier. Okay. Yeah, in any of these programs, there's always going to be multiple ways of doing things. But if one is easier for you, please try it out that way. Okay. There we go. See, our painting is starting to come along here. I know it takes a little while sometimes, but we'll get there. Alright. And depending on how much time you have, if you want to make a few different trees, I think that would look great as well. Alright, awesome. Got a whole bunch here now, I think. There we go. Nice. So, again, if it's closer, or if it's bigger, it should be closer to give that good depth effect. Okay, cool. So we've got lots of them there. And you know what? I think I even want to replace this one. It was a good starter, but let's get rid of that one. Maybe we'll take this one over here. All right, awesome. And remember, the closer it is, I think this is the closer side. Oh, if you end up moving your sky, that's okay. Just put it back there. Yeah, let's make this one a lot bigger to give a nice depth effect. Very cool. See, it's coming along. I know it takes a little while. All right, my friends. We've made some good progress on the basics of our painting, but I wanted us to take a second look at our photo inspiration to take a look at what colors are happening for our sunset. I do want us to work on the sky layer next, but to do that, let's take a quick peek. I think we've got some oranges, some yellows, some pinks maybe, some blues, a blue-gray up there at the top, but I want you to know we can make our sky any way that we want and have as much fun as we want. So let's head back to our drawing now. I want to teach you a new trick. So we're going to create a new layer for our sky and we're going to go empty. But this layer is on top of the tree layers, the two trees that we have there, and it's on top of our background. So to add on some more paint to the sky, I want to put this layer just above our background layer. So we've got our two trees And we've got our sky layer here. And we're going to learn about the gradient tool next. Basically, it's going to let us blend some different colors. But to do that, let's just select our sky area. So let's grab our select tool. I know this one is new for us as well. So this lets you select a section, and then we'll be able to use one of those tools to affect it. So I'm just going to see if I can grab an area that will create like a flat skyline, which is always really nice. Good horizon line there. Perfect. And from there, I want to choose a color. So I've already chosen a really cheerful orange that I liked. And let's go over to our gradient tool here. And we can affect it. Right now it's on linear, which is what we're after. And we already noticed that the sunset goes from a darker color to a more light color. But we could change it however we like. So let's see. We could even make it less transparent if we wanted. Or even perhaps many colors. But for our purpose right now, let's choose two. So we've got our orange and our yellow. And then if we draw up, so if we put our pointer somewhere around here, we click and then we hold and drag up. We should get a nice transition there. I think I have almost too much orange though, so I want to try again. If you want to try again, you can just go edit, undo. And let's see, I think I want less orange, so I'm just going to try little less and see what we get. Oh, that's nice. Okay. I like that. But again, if you want to try one more time, you can to get a different effect. Okay. I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, so we've taken a break and we're back to our picture again. I wanted to take a look this time at some of the ground and decide how are we going to represent that in our painting and what will also be really fun. Okay. When I did look at the ground there, I saw lots of different greens. I saw some browns. I saw some yellows. I saw all different shades all in there. So let's see if we can recreate that in our painting here. So I realize we may have created many, many, many layers, and that is totally okay. Now we will need to create a new layer because we're going to work on the grass, and I want to work on that on our own without affecting any of the trees or the sky or anything else. So let's take layer 19 or whatever layer number you're at, and we just need to drag it down. And I want it under the sky and on top of our background. So see, we've got layer one, and now we want the layer that we're going to work on, and then the sky layer. This way, we can play around with some different tools, and we won't go over that horizon line. We can just work in here and on this side. And I've decided I want to try this parallel tool. It looks really fun, and I had put it at the 17, but maybe I'll go even smaller. So that also, you can choose maybe a green that you like. Any green will do. I want to start out with this muted color though. Let's start out with the dark shades and then work up from there. Okay, but here, just so you can see what it looks like, we should be able to paint right now under the sky and under all those trees. Let's see. If I click and drag, I get something like that. If I just click, I get sort of a random assortment of things. But if you see there, it's painting under. That's exactly what I was hoping for. Awesome. But yeah, I definitely wanted these little blobs. Maybe get some texture for our grass. Might even try a smaller brush. But realizing smaller brush is just going to take us longer. So let's go back up maybe. So we can start to see this effect come through pretty quickly. There we go. So there's our green, and I think I'll do a lot of the darker colors near the back, but I do want to layer some colors in. So let's see, I know I'm over on the riverside a little bit more now. There we are. Okay, I do have another green ready to go, so I'm going to start getting in some other colors just to get some little bit of contrast. Maybe I want a little more contrast. So let's get maybe even a gray. Oops. There we go. And I think I'll put some of those blobs up at the front. Just make sure you're having fun. And everyone's is going to look a little bit different. I don't expect yours to look like mine. Okay, so we've got some of that. But remember, we did have some other colors as well. So I think we had like a light yellow, since it's still just coming up on spring. Oops, and you know what? Let's start working on this side as well. Get some grass in there. I do kind of like the texture. I know we have a lot of different things going on in this painting, but this way you get to see what it would look like with some detailed effects there, some gradient effects, and also learning this pen tool. Okay. Yeah, we're definitely starting to see our painting come alive here. And then, if you ever, forget which color you had, you can use this eyedropper tool and then just hover over a color that you have on your screen to get back to that dark green. So that is a really handy tool. That's the eyedropper tool, or the picker tool. Let's go back to our pen. And again, yeah, you can adjust your sizes. I'm going to go a little bit bigger on this side since this side is a little bit closer. I guess we also wanted some in the background. Creating a little bit of texture, some fun colors. All right, well, that went a little bit too much. I think I want some lighter colors on top of that. Maybe even something a little more green would be nice, a little brighter. Maybe that'll be a little cheerful. It's kind of fun to see how different greens can give you different, even a different mood to your painting. I know this is a little bit bright for our sunset, but very cheerful. Okay. Let's see how we can get the edges kind of textured out. Get rid of that outline that we had there. And next we'll work on our water. And then, we're just about done. Okay, so I think I'm pretty happy with that. Maybe a couple finishing touches, and we'll decide what to do with our water next. Okay, my friends, so I've given you a preview here of what we're going to do with the water now that we've finished up the land and the sky and the trees. So in order to reproduce this, I'm just going to hide that layer. So yours probably looks something like this right now. Okay, so let's go through those steps again. We're gonna create a new layer, and we're gonna create the empty layer. And remember, that usually goes all the way up to the top. So let's bring that down. There we go. And we just want this right above your main base layer. Okay, so let's learn about a new effect, or a couple new things here. So we were on parallel, that was pretty cool, but I think this will look nice with a crayon. And we're going to use that eyedropper tool again and grab the colors that we have here, okay? Because our actual water should probably mirror the sky. So let's grab that and let's go back to our crayon. And let's see what size we have. Okay, that seems like a nice size. And look, we can draw behind because we are on that bottom layer. So this is kind of the fun part. We can just kind of squiggle in that new color really fast. All right. Awesome. Yeah, I don't really like that darker blue anymore. I'm kind of done with that. Okay, so that's looking good, and then I'm going to eyedropper in one of these sun colors. Maybe I'll grab that kind of greenish color, that's interesting, and color that in. Let's just squiggle it in. We're not going to squiggle everything in, just a little bit. And I still want to try to get rid of some of that purple. Okay, so basically anything in your sky is going to be reflected in your water. So I guess we really want a bit more yellow in the middle here. So maybe we'll pop and put in a bit more yellow. And some of our orange here, I want to do a bit closer. So it kind of matches up, right? Okay, that's looking good. I like that it even kind of curves a little. And remember, some pieces will move through no matter what. I think I do want a little more blue. Got a little carried away there. I do want some blue. Okay. That's looking pretty good. And then I do want a dark color. So yeah, let's see. Have we mirrored the red or the orange and then the yellow? I think I want maybe one more yellow because I know we have a few different tones. We got that sort of greenish tone, but maybe we can get a little bit more red to get like a really nice effect there. So let's see. I think that other orange kind of comes in here. Yeah, nice. And then let's sprinkle it in a bit more. Just smattering all over here. Cool. But of course it's nighttime, so I think we're gonna need to darken it up. If we do look back at our photo, let me see if I can bring it into your screen here. There we go. I think you can also see that. There is the shadows, right? The shadows of the trees. So maybe we can bring that in a little. Maybe a nice gray. Let's see. How can we do that? Smattering of the trees there. And then, once we're done this, we're going to actually add a liquefying effect, so I think that should be pretty fun, too. And see, there's like a bit more in certain areas than others. That'll just make it a bit more fun. And then again, if you want, I would go back in, add a bit more of the blue, just so everyone remembers that we're looking at the water here. A little bit of a continuation going. Awesome. Okay, and yeah, work on it for a little bit. Probably want it all the way through a little bit. And then we're going to change it all up in just a moment. Maybe a little more orange. Have some orange on this side. Cool. Okay. So the last thing, one of the last things we'll learn today is this liquify tool. So this is really, really neat. If you click and drag, you're going to create that cool look. And you can adjust it too. So I think I did crank up my density here. If it wasn't so dense, just like the preset, it sort of makes everything a little more pointy. I'm going to undo what I just did. Okay. Yeah, I do want to up the density a little bit. And I probably up the strength a little bit. And the size. I put mine at 50. Oh, and you know what? I turned down my strength. So let's see if we can see what the default would look like. Default. Yeah, you got these pointy ones, which are okay, but if we compare to our picture, I think it's more sedated than that. So let's maybe turn it down a little bit. Turn down the strength, turn up the density. Let's undo a couple times there. Okay, so how I did this effect was I went down once and then up the next one, and then down and then up. And then down, and then up, down, and then up, down, and then up. And let's see, how did we do there? Oh, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Okay, and then, yeah, play with it as much as you want. Try to blend it all in, get a lot of, like, different facets going there. Because I know on the picture we have lots of little ripples. It's pretty fun. And you know what? Maybe some of them are different than others. Maybe some are smaller ripples. What does that look like? Let's see. Yeah, there we go. We got some smaller ripples in there now. So they're not all the same size. That looks really cool. Alright, yeah, that's awesome. Hopefully you're having fun with the liquify tool as well. And so yeah, you can see that anytime you do this, it's going to be different. Maybe I'll change... What else could I change up here? Density... If we crank it up a little more, maybe we want a few that are bigger. Oh no, I don't know if I want that. That's really neat. Okay. Yeah, it looks like we could definitely soften things out if you like. A little bit more movement that way. That's cool. Now I want to go back a couple steps and see which one I like better. You know what? I think I do like adding that big swath right, and then that big swath left. Maybe another swath right. It does really change up the image. So I think you'll have to decide. Maybe just I'll do the one swath. Huh. Very cool. Okay. And then, again, we can compare, so let's make the other layer visible. That was one. Oh, you know what? We made that one transparent. So, see, we did put two layers on top if you want. So that's the single layer. That's if you want to add a second layer. And that was what I came up with originally, and it looks like the second time through, yeah, we added a lot more shadow. Looks like we got a better effect there. Very interesting. So yeah, each time you do this, you'll probably learn a little bit more. Everything will look a bit different. So let's see. Without the second layer. With the second layer. Oh, that's really interesting. Okay, you know what? I think I'm going to leave a second layer on. I think it adds a little kind of luminousness. Okay. So let's see, did we forget to add anything to this giant art project? My goodness. Let's take a look at the photo and see. Looks like we just missed our birds. Okay, so we'll add our birds next. Okay, my friends, so over here I've added a new layer. And just if you forget, you just add it there. And then this time we want to draw the birds on the top layer. So we're just going to leave that layer right where it is. Let's go over to our brush tool. Here we go. And let's grab a dark color. And let's just see, how can we draw in some birds here? Something like that. You know what though? I think I want to change up the brush just a tiny bit. To be a little less fuzzy. So let's try. Sometimes it's the detail stuff that's tough, right? But there's one of them. And there's our second one. Alright. I'm gonna give that second one another try. Seems to be the second one that's the winner here. All right, so we've got our birds. Maybe we'll extend those wings a little bit more. There we go. Oh, that's too much. Okay. Awesome. So I hope you will let us know if you complete the project or what you came up with on your own. Looking forward to seeing them. And you can use hashtag Maiden Hefner Or you can email me, emilymclaughlin@kpl.org, and you'll see that in the slides to follow up. Awesome. Hope everyone has a great day, and we'll see you again soon.